Hello, law aspirants. I'm Akriti, the founder of the Legal Chronicle. Now, today we have with us Aditya Sankar Dixit, a fourth-year law student of NLIU Bhopal. Now, if you want a sneak peek to how your life is going to be like in law school, follow us on The Legal Chronicle. The description box has the link to our page. Hello, Aditya. Could you give me a brief introduction of your college?
So my name is Aditya, as I've already been introduced by Akriti ma'am. And my college is National Law Institute University in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. It was one of the first three NLUs that was established in the country. And it was established, I think, according to the NLIU Act of 1997 by the Madhya Pradesh Legislative Assembly. And yeah, that's about it. It's the second act to be passed with respect to a national law university. Yeah.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that fact, actually. So yeah, let's move to combinations which are available for students.
So there are a lot of courses offered. There's the MCLIS course that's offered for masters in computer law, cyber law, sorry. Then there is the master's program in various different areas of law, constitutional law, for instance, or environmental law. But unfortunately, our college just offers the BA LLB honors program. Okay. It doesn't offer the BCom LLB honors or any other combination as such. But I think the BA, given the amount of students that there are in our college, which is just what, I think there are a total of 600 kids in the BA LLB program. And I think that's sort of not a very diverse group of people, because most of them come from Madhya Pradesh. So I think it really doesn't matter. I was a humanities student, so it's great for me.
Okay. And do you have LLM as well, or there's no LLM?
We do. As I said, we do have an LLM program, and it's with respect to, you know, constitutional law, environmental law, etc. There are multiple areas in which you can do an LLM. Okay. So yeah, we do have LLM programs in our college.
Okay, so one of the most important questions every law student wants to know is with respect to attendance. Okay, because that is a problem for most of the students, because they also would like to do other things along with college. So what is the attendance requirement?
So while we do have a 75% minimum attendance requirement, this year it's been a little up in the air. You know, nobody is very clear as to what the exact rule is, because we have just, like, at the beginning of my fourth year, we shifted from a trimester system to a semester system, right? And I think the 75% minimum requirement is there, but I can assure anybody who wants to join a law college that you get plenty of time to do other things. There is absolutely, it's just 4 hours of classes a day, and the rest of the day is completely yours. You can do whatever you want.
Okay, that's great. What about in terms of location? Where is it located and how far is it from the city?
So, the campus is located on this beautiful hillock just outside of the main city. And it's the drive to the main city is around 15 to 20 minutes, give or take, depending on the kind of vehicle you take. But it's right next to all the dams. You know, Bhopal is known as the city of lakes. I'm sure you know that. Yes. And it's located right next to the picturesque Kerwa Dam in Bhopal. It sounds very, very,
yeah,
it sounds beautiful, and it really is. It's a lot of fun. It's really nice. I mean, we do notice a lot of wildlife in the area. If you, if you're lucky, you can actually, you know, come across tigers and whatnot.
Wow.
In that area. So it's really beautiful.
Okay. So is there a dress code in the campus?
No, there is no dress code. Just that you have to be smart casuals when you go to class. Apart from that, you can wear whatever you want. There is no such dress code.
Yeah. Okay. So let's come to academics, right? Starting with the faculty. So what is the quality of faculty and the student-teacher ratio?
Okay, so the student-teacher ratio, I'd like to begin with that, because I think that's very important when it comes to legal education. The student-teacher ratio is 1 to 50. So the batches are divided into half, and it's 1 to 50. But I can assure you that there is a lot of engagement. between the students and the professors. We have some of the best faculty in the country. I'd say, for instance, Professor Ghayur Alam, who is also the IPR law chair for the Ministry of, I think, the Ministry of Education, Human Resource, yeah, MHRD, my apologies, yes, MHRD. We have Professor Uday Pratap Singh, who's an alumnus of the Jawaharlal Nehru University. He's also, and he teaches human rights. He's exceptional. He's in his way, in his syllabus and everything. And these are just some of the professors that are there. Of course, our Vice Chancellor, Mr. Professor Dr. V. Vijay Kumar, an exceptional professor in constitutional law, also the chair for the United Nations Human Rights Committee in India. And he's, so we have a lot of, we have a very vibrant group of faculty, and they're exceedingly engaging with students. Although, to be very honest, some onus does also fall on the student to engage with your professor, which I think is there everywhere. So I think that's not a huge deal. But yeah, we have a great, great. Yeah, yeah, they're very approachable. In fact, they encourage, recently, since I've joined college at least, the engagement is more encouraged between professors and students. Yeah.
Okay. Now, moving on to the resources, right? In terms of databases, what are the resources available to students?
So you have all the regular databases that are available to students in general. You have Manupatra, you have SCC, you have Hine Online, JSTOR. Moreover, the library is beautiful. It's one of the best places to work in the college, I think. It's just, it's got a very, very extensive collection of books on IP law, on international law. It's got an extensive collection on, say, sociology, history, economics, and, you know, and the like. Moreover, it has all the bare acts that you will need throughout your law college life, all the commentaries that you will need. And yeah, that's about it. It's got some very exclusive versions as well. For instance, we have the Shabtai Rosen's book on the law and the law and procedure of the International Court of Justice, which is a 4-volume work, which I think is one of the best works on international law out there. Moreover, you have other legal books as well, which are very, very good. For instance, Sirvai or D.D. Basu, etc., you know, all of that. Yeah.
So in terms of resources, your college is also really great, right?
Yeah, now, it is.
Yes. So, yeah, moving on to the internships and placements. So every law student, like law student or a law aspirant, everyone wants to know what is the support you get from college in terms of internships and placements.
So we do have a very vibrant PCC, or the Placement Coordination Committee. They have a very, very, they're very, you know, on the job when it comes to the placements and for internships of students. And we do get a lot of good placements and internships from the big seven firms in India. In fact, we're still placing a lot of students. We recently had the highest number of PPOs or pre-placement offers, for those who don't know that, in our history last year. Okay. So I think it's a very vibrant culture. Moreover, your professors are always there to guide you. They're always sending us emails about, you know, internship opportunities outside of law firm. Okay. Moreover, the seniors and the, and you know, the peers that you have, they're also very, very engaged in guiding you, as long as you seek that guidance. Obviously, nobody's going to come up to you and tell you that you should do this. But yeah, we have a very, very vibrant senior group of seniors who always are willing to help out with internships and whatnot.
Okay. Now, moving on to co-curriculars, because we know in law school, mooting research papers are one or two things which are very, very important and highly valuable as well. So what is the kind of mooting culture in your college?
Okay, so with respect to mooting, I think we have one of the most vibrant mooting cultures across national law universities. We participate regularly in the Philip C. Jessup Moot Court competition. I myself just finished up with that. We've had people go up to the quarterfinals of that moot. Then we have, you know, we've 2 years we have produced, not consecutively, but 2 years we've produced students who've gone up to the finals of the Stetson International Environmental Law Moot Court competition. And we've qualified for that moot 3 years in a row, won it twice out of that in the national rounds. So that's been a very, very good experience for all of us. Moreover, with respect to, say, the WIS, William C. WIS competition that's held both in Vienna mm-hmm. and in Hong Kong. We've mm-hmm. done well at both. I think we've gone up to quarters or semis, if I'm not wrong. And we've also gone up to, in the WIS East competition, that is. And we've also gone up to, I think, round of 32, if I'm not mistaken, round of 64 in the WIS Vienna competition. And, you know, these are just some of the moots that I'm discussing. Obviously, there are like tons mm-hmm. more that students from our mm-hmm. college do and they do well at. Yeah.
Yes. So, yeah, now we know that we are amidst a pandemic, right? And one of the most important things is, how is the mental well-being of students managed, and what is the kind of relationships does the student and the administration have?
So I think this is one thing where my university has done really well for itself. What they've done is, so the UGC recently came out, or the government of India actually came out with a new education policy, right? Under that, the UGC mandated that students be appointed guides or rather, you know, mentors in the form of professors. And our college has been very proactive in assigning mentors to us. And fortunately, touchwood, all of our mentors have been very, very concerned about our mental health. You know, they've been in regular touch with us about everything that's going on. In fact, our college did appoint a guidance counselor, or like a therapist, so to speak, a while back. And, you know, a lot of students ended up going to that professor to discuss things recently because of how the pandemic is, you know, affecting everybody's mental health. So I think our college has done very well for us and for itself in, you know, giving us that space we need.
That kind of support is very, very important, yeah. Especially in times like this, right? So are these mentors students, or are they just professors, or are they counselors? What is the kind of, who are the kind of people?
So the counselors are, the mentors rather, are our professors.
Okay.
And it's sort of also in a bid to create better relationships between professors and students.
Okay.
And because the professors also understand what kind of problems that we are going through, because, mm-hmm. you know, it's a very small community in NLIU. It's just around 900 people living on campus together. So they realize that we also miss college and we need to come back and we want to restart college and everything. So it's really great to have somebody who knows your problems and to interact with them. Moreover, the student community in itself has a very, very strong bond with each other. So you have seniors who don't remain your seniors, who become like part of your group and part of your social circle, who become friends, very close friends rather. So I think that's it really helps, you know, having that space with your friends and your professors. So yeah, I think the college is doing pretty well in that sense.
So apart from all the good things we discussed about your college, I would like you to maybe list out some demerits you think is.
So I can't think of any demerits off the top of my mind, to be very honest. I spent four years in this college, and when I did come to college, it was a very different experience for me. I had never lived in a hostel. At that time, I only saw demerits. But now it's very difficult for me to, you know, look at that, except for the fact that the biggest demerit right now is that I'm not in campus.
Yes. I understand.
Yeah, I'm really not in campus. And that really bugs me out. Like, it's really not nice to not be in that place. Apart from that, I think one thing that I would say is a problem, or not a problem, is maybe a demerit, is that there is a lot of distance sometimes between students. I mean, I think, but that extends to most law colleges. Since you brought up the topic of mental mm-hmm. well-being and mental health,
yes.
Because you're competing for the same opportunities with each other, right? Mm-hmm. The opportunities are extremely limited. Mm-hmm. I think that sort of creates a very cutthroat sort of environment.
Yes.
But but I don't think it's nothing that can't be overcome with the proper guidance. I mean, there should be healthy competition. But, you know, and I don't think it's a university issue per se. I think it's a profession issue, more like, right?
That's
so that, you know, there's some sort of health, there needs to be some sort of healthiness in the competition, is all I'm saying.
actually, so we did realize that. And the Legal Chronicle started a community called SLAM just to overcome that part of it. So what it is like a Facebook group where all law students, like all our students from the Moot Masters Club and from the Legal Research Course, come into it. And every Friday, 8 p.m., we just, you know, chill and do different fun things. For example, we had one session on just discussing the Batman movie. So we are just coming together and, you know, just thinking out loud. Then I think one of my favorite sessions was Venting Out, where all students came on board like on a Zoom call, and it was anonymous entirely. And since I'm a peer educator, we sat together and we just asked the students to vent out. And I think that is the kind of bond that was created among students when you are in the most vulnerable place you can be. I think that really helped the students, you know, bond more. And since we have a Facebook group, it is something like, oh, you want an internship in Delhi? Here's where I did it. So it's a give and take. So I think we need more communities like this in the country altogether, you know, to eliminate all kind of the extra unhealthy competition, especially.
You know, in fact, our college is doing that. So there's a cell in our college called Athena. It's the cultural cell in our college. And in addition to the other, which is the extracurricular activity cell, the Youth Cultura. And, you know, both of these cells do activities like this. For instance, say debating practice, you can just come and, you know, talk about what you want to say. Then we have open mic nights in college where you can just, you know, do stand-up comedy, sing something, put on a performance and stuff like that. So we have, you know, activities like this that, for instance, I remember in my second year, the Football World Cup was going on when we'd just gone back to college, I think in June and July. And, you know, we used to have this community football watching scene where all of us used to go to the auditorium. And, okay, I didn't go, I'll be very honest. I'm not a football fan. But it's a good idea. Like, I think it's a really good idea that, you know, all students went to the auditorium.
Okay, so I have been a hostler for like 4 or 5 years in my school. And those football matches and World Cup, all of those are like times when everyone comes together and everyone's having snacks and enjoying their time. I think that's the best of all, right? So, coming back to the questions. Okay, I think this is the last question. And this is, on a scale of 1 to 10, would you recommend your college to the other students who are watching this video and any other CLAT aspirant?
Yes, I would. 10 on 10. I would definitely do that. As long as they don't, if they have a bad experience, as long as they don't come and, you know, try to beat me up or something, I definitely recommend it. I mean, the 4 years that I've had in NLIU, or like the 3 years rather, have been some of the best years of my life. I've met some of the best people through this college, in this college. I have done some of the things that I'm most proud of because of NLIU, because I am in NLIU. And I just absolutely love the experience that I've had here.
So that's about it for tonight. And thank you, Aditya, for coming on board with us and answering all our questions. And I'm sure all the students who are watching this video would be really thankful. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you.